Welcome to Juniper Networks KBTV SRX and STRM series. This video will demonstrate how to forward traffic logs from an SRX device to an STRM Syslog server. For a text version of these instructions, please refer to article KB16224. The URL is provided at the end of this video. This video will be helpful for IT administrators who want to send traffic logs, or structured syslogs, from an SRX device to an STRM syslog server. We will complete this task in two parts. In the first part, we will cover the steps needed to configure an SRX device to send traffic logs, also referred to as data plane logs, to an STRM device using a structured format. We will then demonstrate how to view the traffic logs on the STRM device. To send SRX system logs, also referred to as control logs, to an STRM device, refer to KB29539. Part 1, Configuring the SRX. These are the steps we will follow to configure the SRX device. For step 1, we will set the security log mode. There are two possible completions for the command set security log mode, as shown here. We are going to select stream for this example. To use the stream mode, enter the following command, set security log mode stream. For step 2, we set the security log format to sd-syslog. Use the command set security log format sd-syslog, where the sd-syslog option means structured syslog format. We need to specify structured syslog, since STRM expects the SRX traffic, or data plane logs, in this format. For step 3, we set the security log source address. The source address field is used to specify the SRX IP address expected by the STRM device. It is important to point out that because we are logging in stream mode, which we configured in step 1, the traffic logs must be sent from a revenue port on the SRX. A revenue port is any port that is not FXP0. Here we are using the IP address of an egress interface GE000 on the SRX. For more information on this restriction, refer to the links in KB article KB16224. Step 4, we will set the security log stream. We need to give our security stream log a name and category. We can use anything for the name. We used security log here. We also set the category to all. Setting category to all will include all of the severities. Step 5. We will set the host IP of the STRM device. Use the following command to set the host IP address of the STRM or syslog server device that will receive the traffic logs. In this example, security log is the log name we specified in the previous step. Step 6, we will set the host port used by the STRM device. Use the following command to set the host port of the STRM device that will collect the traffic logs. This is the port the STRM device is configured to listen on. The default syslog port is 514. This concludes the configuration portion of the SRX device. We will go ahead and perform a commit at this point. Part 2. View traffic logs on the STRM device. Access the STRM Admin Web interface and choose Log Source to display the available logs. STRM auto-detects an SRX device as a Juniper Junos OS platform. You can also manually create the log source as an SRX device. Both Device Support Modules, or DSMs, will parse log data correctly. The status of success for the log source entry for the SRX confirms the logs are being sent to the STRM device. For more information, refer to the Security Threat Response Manager Log Sources User's Guide. If we close the log source view and click on the Log Activity tab, we can verify that logging is being sent to the STRM from the SRX device in real time. For more information, such as the text format of this video, more KBTV technical videos, and our support site, you can visit these URLs. Thanks for watching.